A minor leaguer is assigned temporarily to a new role.
Hey, it's SGU, and we are back with the Dog Bones Road to the Show series here in MLB The Show 19. How are you guys enjoying the new game so far? I'm loving it so far, and I'm loving Dog Bones being back.
Always looking to fill needs, clubs will explore every way a prospect might be capable of contributing.
So if you missed yesterday's episode, first of all, shame. You're in the doghouse. You need to go watch that. But anyway, what you missed is that we have a position change. We've been asked to play some right field now, and we want to be that team player, that heart and soul guy, the captain type player. So we want to lead by example, and so we're obviously not going to tell him no to playing a new position, even if we might not be that comfortable. We're talking to a teammate here, trying to build relationships. We need some bros on this team. We need some bros to unlock some stuff. And so far, no bros. So we got to work on that. So here it is, his first appearance out in right field. Oh, I hope this goes well. Ball hit to him. Of course it is.
Fetch, dog. Fetch.
Will he fetch the first ball hit to him? Yes. Gets behind it and in position to actually come up throwing to the cutoff man. Nice job with the runner on base. Okay. So far, so good for Dog Bones out in the outfield. And you see we had to make a new fetch animation. Now that he's no longer a third baseman for the time being. And here is a second in an attempt. And oh, he broke the wrong way on his first step, but he has time to recover and catches that in the gap in right center field. Okay, 2-for-2 out in the outfield. We haven't embarrassed ourselves yet. You guys remember the Champ Kind series, those of you guys that have been around? You remember how many mistakes we made out in the outfield? We actually had blooper reels once in a while, as he would cartwheel around and miss the baseball. And I'm hoping Dog Bones doesn't have to have blooper reels. This ball was hit pretty well, but not well enough. It's going to be caught out by the warning track, and Dog is 0-for-1 in the game. We're playing the Blue Wahoos, Pensacola, which, by the way, I think are now my hometown Minnesota Twins' new AA affiliate. That's pretty cool. Dynamic challenge coming up. What do we got? Power swing to drive in a run? Go for it all. We like to go big when possible. So let's see if we can power swing and drive in a runner from first base. That means we need a gapper, or we need a home run. Will he come up with it? Well, not on that pitch. Swing and a miss. Could feel the air from that one all the way back here. That one's hit hard, but that's a line drive and it's caught. So obviously that's going to fail our challenge. How about bases loaded up 1-0 in the fifth? Two outs. Big spot here. Can he come through? Grounded to third base. He's going to make the play and the throw across the diamond. The long throw, he's got him. He's got him by about a step and a half. And Dog Bones cannot come through in the clutch there with the bases loaded. We had a talk from the manager the other day about being clutched. I guess right there is what he was talking about out in right field. And this ball's going to be hit behind us.
Fetch, dog, fetch.
Yes, dog, please fetch that baseball. He finds the wall, puts a hand out, turns around, and makes the catch on the warning track. Like a seasoned pro right there. He even knew his surroundings. He found the wall first. Okay, he must be a quick learner out there, as things going pretty smoothly so far. He had one misstep on a first step on a fly ball, but he recovered. And we haven't seen anything disastrous yet. Kind of disastrous is his 0-for-3 start at the plate today. However, this is crushed in. The left fielder has no time to even leap for that. It's over his head. And that is going to be a double. Hustles in there, head first slide. And he also drives in a run. That gives Mississippi the lead and prompts the pitching coach to come out for a talk. It must not be helping. Base is loaded now with one out. That's put down the first baseline. Was that a bunt? Or was that a little swinging bunt? I don't know. Either way, it's not fielded at third base cleanly. Everyone's safe. Dog Bones scores. Let's take a look at this again. He is indeed dropping a bunt down, a safety squeeze of sorts. Now, that's a little dangerous because they got the force at home, but you got to come up with the play. You're forcing him to make a play, and he did not do it right there. Kind of breaks this game open. It's now 9-4 in the eighth inning. You're going to hit a fly ball here that's not dangerous at all. Going to be caught by the center fielder. So it looks like just one hit tonight for Dog, but at the time, it gave his team the lead. And it looks like they are going to go on to win this one at home against the Blue Wahoos. Right there, the victory is picked up by the Mississippi Braves. 9-4 is your final, the final score line for Dog Bones. He has that RBI double, scores a run himself. But obviously, you know, he wants multiple hit games. He's used to that. And just one in a game, not really how he wants to go down. But we'll check out another game in this series with Pensacola. They got two runners on with two out and an 0-2 count. Can we keep them off the scoreboard? Whoa, okay, that's the first time he's broken the wrong way. Luckily, he does have time to turn around. He'll get docked for his reaction right there. But it's the recovery we're worried about. Hey, you're making the catch, and we can live with that. We can live with the growing pains out there. You're showing that you're willing to learn a new position and help the team, and maybe in turn help yourself fast-track yourself to the majors. Maybe right field is where the need is more, and they see him contributing out there if he can be solid. Dog's first at bat of the day results in a ground out, so we'll come up here for the second time, hitting 380 now, just a shade under 400. We were at 500 at one point, but like I said, it was super early, not a whole lot of at-bats under the belt, and here you go. We're going for the dynamic goal. We picked getting a hit in the first three pitches, so let's see if we can do that. First pitch, he swings, and is it going to be a hit? It sure is. It's in the gap off the MLB Network sign. They get this in, and it's going to be extra bases for Dog, so he does exactly what he needs, and this time, he earns his blue ribbon.
The winner for best of show is Dog Bones.
Yep, doing exactly what he set out to do this time, worthy of a replay. Tagged hard, and the left fielder can do nothing but chase it to the wall. Good job right here. Where was this pitch in the zone? In and low. It's a cutter, but he's able to turn that around with ease. They don't score, though, so Pensacola up 1-0. Still here in the top of the sixth inning. This one quite easy. We just got to kind of jog in, make the catch, and get that back in the infield so the runners don't go anywhere. Broke the right way on the baseball that time. Instincts a little better. Then the first ball we handled. So 1-for-2 with that double. And he's got another at bat. Another dynamic challenge as well. What are we going to do? Record a hit by the first three pitches again. All right, let's see if we're successful again. Can we pull it off? Runner at first. One out. First pitch is going to be hit. And, oh, get down. Instead, it's a frozen rope line drive right at the left fielder. Challenge failed. Didn't get our ribbon that time. Not best in show. Let's come back strong next time. We show up for the dog show. All right. Yep. That time is right now, apparently. We've got all sorts of dynamic challenges in this game. Let's do contact swing. And we need to use it to drive in a run. We're up 4-2. We got a runner at second base. Very feasible here. You got to make contact, though. Misses for strike one. Trying to stay within himself there. You see him working on his hands and his swing mechanics. He's going to come up with a hit there. The runner to the plate. He will be safe. Look at that. He did it. Challenge accepted. Challenge completed. Dynamic challenge. Check mark, baby.
The winner for best of show is Dog Bones.
All right, so that's a couple dynamic challenges he has been able to clear today, and the Braves get the victory. All is good. Couple hits, and it's looking good for Dog Bones. Like I said, he likes multiple hit games. This is exactly that, a double and a single in this one, and he does his job. So, Dog, looking at the schedule here, we're going to clear these games with Pensacola. Had enough with them.
A player new to his AA squad gets a tip from one of his coaches.
Oh, let's see. What do we have here this time? He's just reminding us of the ability to get an extra practice on the practice field. Okay, good to know. Good to know. Thanks for the info. Moving on, it's the Montgomery Biscuits hosting us this time. We played the Biscuits before, but I think it was at our field now. Dog Bones in search of those biscuits. Every good dog wants to get a biscuit, right? Now let's see if we can go ahead and get us some treats in this game as this ball's hit deep and it is going to hop over the wall in one hop. That is a ground rule double. We've had lots and lots of doubles already in this series. This is the first ground rule double we've hit. So we get to jog into second base instead of hustling and sliding. Base is loaded, nobody out. Big opportunity here. That's actually going to be a double play ball, which is about the worst thing that could happen, but the run does score. Dog touches home plate, and it's 1-0 Mississippi Braves. The Dog Bones right field experiment continues as this ball is hit deep.
Fetch, dog, fetch.
Come on and fetch it, dog. Oh, yeah. Nope, he's not fetching that one. That hits off the back of the bullpen wall, and it is a home run. Nothing dog can do about that to bring it back. And we got a 1-1 ball game. Watch it again, as this is hammered by the left-handed hitter. And, yeah, no wall climb or anything is going to bring that thing back. No way. So we are tied at one, bottom of the second inning, and we got another chance. This one towards the left field line. Don't really have to move a whole lot to get that one. Very routine, and the catch is made. Okay. All right. Much more manageable that we can actually take care of. Got to keep it in the ballpark, and then we can think about making catches for you. So dog one for one with that double and a run scored. What can he do for an encore? How about a base hit right up the middle? And he is going to single to center field. Two for two is dog bones now. Multiple hit game already. And he's on base, ready for some teammates to do some damage. First of all, we look at a couple replays of his sweet swing. Bryce Harper stance. By the way, did you see Bryce Harper go off against his old team last night, hitting the home run, and that epic bat flick? Oh, the shade thrown. Here's another routine ball out to right field. And that catch is indeed made routinely. Good job, Dog Bones, holding down the new position. So far, nothing to cause alarm. All right, so he's two for two. Maybe trying to work that batting average up close to 400 again. It'd be quite a feat to carry that for a whole season at any level. That's a potential double play ball, but it was bobbled a little bit. And because of that, Dog Bones will be safe at first on the fielder's choice. Runner erased at second base, but Dog is on. And the manager wants him to steal. Okay, we haven't really seen this yet, and we haven't worked up to the point where we have showtime to put on there like I like to do to get that good jump. And, yeah, we're not a base stealer by any means at this point. It was kind of ridiculous to send us, but, hey, that's what the manager wanted. He called for it, and he got us run out of the inning. All right. Clearly we have goals there to work on our speed and our base stealing abilities. 2-2 baseball game right now. That's slicing to right center, and they're not going to catch that. That's going to be extra bases. That's going to get him to second. Is he going to go for third? No, no. We're not going to triple dog dare him this time, but he is indeed one hot dog. 3-hit ball game for Dog Bones. This one a very hard hit line drive the opposite way, and he finds himself at second base once again. Good game for the dog. Good game for the Braves. We'll find out. Sac fly right there. They take a 3-2 lead, and they take a 3-2 win. Very nice. Getting the job done. Everyone gets to celebrate in the dugout tonight on the Mississippi Braves side. Like I said, 3 hits and also reaching on a fielder's choice. Oh, why not? Give it to him.
Top dog.
Going 3-for-4 in a close, low-scoring game like that merits top dog honors, in my opinion. So when we come back, we'll continue our play out in right field, see how long that's going to last. Are they going to move us back to third base, keep us out in right for good? I don't know, but we'll see you next time for more Dog Bones.
What will Dog Bones watch next on YouTube? Maybe he'll start by watching his own series right here on Sports Gaming Universe. He'd also never forget to subscribe to SGU and to turn on all notifications so he will never miss an episode.